Hello and welcome! This will be just a small overview and a small showcase for my new build, the Stormbrand. You can see all details in the forum post, which I'm going to link under the video. So here I'm just going through some small things, no details. Stormbrand is a nice skill which you place on the ground, and when an enemy comes by, it plays Facehugger and jumps onto the enemy, does damage to the enemy and up to two enemies around him. And if the enemy dies, the Stormbrand falls back to the ground and jumps onto the next enemy. If already enemies are near, they just jump from one to the other. The Stormbrand has a bit other functions than normal spells. As you can see, can be attached and can be detached are two stats. If the Stormbrand lies on the ground, it has a duration of normally 10 seconds, which I increased a bit. And while attached on an enemy, it can be 5.5 seconds. If any of these two numbers are depleted, the Stormbrand will vanish. So if it's constantly attached, for example, to a boss, it will vanish after 5.5 seconds. If the enemy dies before the attachment time is zero, it will continue to the detached time. And the remaining duration time for being attached is still saved. So it can stay up to almost 16 seconds, 17 seconds, if it switches from attached to ground mode. We have a bit of support here. I've got myself a nice Wrath Aura, and the rest is a decoy totem to take off problems, so we can run around without having to fear being hit by anything. We have, well, this focus thing is absolutely optional. It's for like something like this. We have an increased duration of ailments, which makes it easier to freeze stuff and make the freeze go longer. It's totally optional. You can play around with it. It's absolutely not mandatory. Then we have the Brand Recall. This is even almost more important than the Stormbrand itself. When you cast the Stormbrands, as mentioned, they jump from enemy to enemy to enemy to enemy, and they're very soon out of sight from anywhere. And if anything comes to you, you press... Oops, I waited too long, that was 11 seconds. And if an enemy comes near to you, you press the button and they're at your side, no matter what they were doing. So even if they're already attached to an enemy or anything, but you get in trouble, you press E. And you do that also while moving through the map, because who cares what's 10 kilometers behind you, where everything is paused and the brands won't do anything while that. So you recall them and they will do damage again. As movement, we have our so beloved flame dash, and then we have a major boss killer. The storm, the Vaal Storm Call already is very strong, but we combine it with the Vaal Righteous Fire. While the burn is okay, it doesn't do anything big to anyone, but it increases our spell damage. While our Stormbrand with my gear already does over 350,000 DPS per brand, the Vaal Righteous Fire will rise it by, will make it a more multiplier with over 36 more spell damage, and that's just insane. And in combination with the Vaal Storm Call, it's absolutely nuts. So that's the short thing about that. We are running a beach map. It's a rather simple one, a bit more monster life, two bosses, and monsters take reduced damage from crit strikes. It's a shaped one, so it's tier 9. It should be totally easy going. I'm going to buff the boss because I need that soul. And here we go. At first, we just throw some crap on the ground and then we're going to flame dash our way around, do some brand recalling, and that's literally all we have to do. On essences, we precast them and they're dead. Try to recall them every about 6 to 10 seconds. Minutes would be nice. And also try to use your brand recall as often as possible, because it doesn't only get you the brands to your side, but it also re-adds 1.5 seconds to brand attachment time and to the time that it's allowed to stay on the ground. So it's very mandatory if you want to keep it alive a lot. And as you can see, the brand goes through everything no matter what you do. You just have to have them active once and jump into stuff and everything melts. Get this and this. And keep in mind, normally you can only have one brand active on an enemy at the same time. But on the tree you get a node where you can add the function to make it two. And you get from the ascendancy a nice bonus of 2% more damage per brand on enemy. Oh, I forgot my flasks. Fuck my life. And that's it. If I would have pulled my flasks, we have had it faster. Because of this baby for some more crit, and this baby for even more crit and a ridiculous regeneration. But that's explained in the forum post, which is linked below. So yeah, as you can see, it's easy, and even with my crap gear, which I'm going to show you here for a short time, so please just pause the video for a second. It's totally nothing special. The only two expensive items have been the lore weave, which I got for 8x, alright, but 5x, and this one which I got for 60 chaos. The rest is self-found or being bought by just a few chaos. Okay, this one was 15 or 20 chaos too when I bought it, but 20 chaos aren't much. Yeah, as you can see, almost no good gear and easy win. You can go through T15 maps in a breeze, absolutely no problem. I hope you liked this video. If yes, leave me a like or anything or whatever, and hope to see you soon. See you!